Okay. Can you see this? Can you? See, this is my first tile to draw. Today, we're going to learn how to draw Toon Link. Just in case none of you know him. Okay. So, here is how you draw Toon Link. First, let's see. I guess you would start off with his sword. Move it down to him. You would bring it here. Then after that, you just bring it over here. And then you have to make this slight change of point right there. Then, and like kind of close to where the handle would be, you put a little line, and then at the shaded spot, bring down that line to the handle. Did you guys get that so far? So it would look like that. Okay. So then after that, what we do is you complete the rectangle. Wait, it's too long. It's gotta be a little shorter actually. You have to make a little rectangle at the back of it. So it's like this. See how at the back I've got that little rectangle? So then after that.
Okay, Anton?
What?
Are you done with your assignment? I need to sign your.
Oh, yes.
Okay, show me your assignment
because
I need to.
Just wait, everyone.
Hey, I bought.
Just. Okay. At the rectangle's crease, you've got to make it like kind of dark, and then shade in the rectangle like this. It's not like that. Then after that, you have to draw a little line out the side, and on the other side, you've got to draw another small line. And that's about in the middle of the rectangle. Then you have to draw like half of a circle going over it. Never mind, not half of a circle. You've got to make it kind of a skinny circle. This shape, ish thing, ish. Then you put a line through it, so it would look like that. And then you put a little bit of it and cross it over, so it's cut in half. See, so then you have like, well, you can't really see it. But above it, there's like this little circle. It's like ting, ting, ting. Because Link's hand is on that. And so that. Wait, is this in the camera? Okay.
Then after that, you've got to draw part of his hand. I'll show you after I do it. Because there's really no point of trying to explain it.
There we go. So then you draw that above it. And that's supposed to be his hand.
Oh, I forgot to tell you. And then shade in that part that was cut in half earlier. Because that's like part of the handle-ish thing. And then you put a line going kind of diagonal. And then on the other side, you put the same thing. So then, like, that's the beginning of his arm. And you would put that. Oops, sorry. So now it looks like that. And then you have to kind of build on his shoulder. So, like, kind of make the line a little long. Like, the line that's on the top, just try to make that a little longer than the one on the bottom. I'm just gonna get an eraser really fast, so I don't have to keep using them. Okay, so I did it wrong actually, so I'm gonna show you the real way. So no, OMG, close the door. This game's so annoying. Okay, so you have to make the line a little longer because that's supposed to be like, right, see how I've got that one longer? That's supposed to be like part of his shoulder. So that one's gonna be a little longer. And then after that, you're gonna have to make a line going like a little bit straight down, kind of. And then a little, like, you have to make it go back up, but not all the way, like, just a little bit not there. And then you put a line through the, like, probably about around the top of the V for it, the shirt that he's got under his shirt. So it would look like that. And then after that, you have to make a little line going right above the shorter part of the V. And then make it kind of go like, kind of make it go kind of down, because that's going to be like the part of his chest. We're not going to get to like where his legs are yet until we finish the upper half, because that's usually how you have to do stuff like this. So like, you've got his chest, and just an easier way is like, draw it. Okay, I'll just show you. So like, his chest starts up here. Just draw it down so it'll be like equal to the hand. That's about how low his chest goes before he's got that like spiral thingy on his belt. So you just have to draw that down until you get to the part of his hand. So then it will look more like this. See how it lines up with his hand? Because I think, yeah. Wait, I'm just gonna stand up and see if that. Yeah, okay. So, yeah, so you do that. And then, yeah, well, I don't know what to do first. Okay, yeah, we'll just do his arm. Okay, so then we're gonna do his right arm. Yeah, it would be on his right, but really on ours it's left. So he would have like a little part of his arm going down, and then you would bring it back up, and then cut it across, even though there's no hand there yet, because you'll add it eventually. And then you put his back up so it looks like his arm. The others. Okay. So then you bring it down and go straight up. Well, straight diagonally. Certain way. And then so it looks like that. And then after that, at the part that you've got his like arm basically, I guess, cut off, draw a short line, and then the short line again on the other side, and bring it up and make another little rectangle. And then shade that kind of a darkish gray, I guess. And then above that, bring up and make a little part of his, the other part of his arm, and bring it up and across. So after you do all that, it would look something like this. Because that's going to be like, he's holding like a shield, kind of. But, and then like, the shield has these two rope things, so at the end of the rectangle, I like these two half circles. Because that's like where the wood's being split into. And then you have to add the part that's being hooked onto. And after that, then you start drawing his hand. So it would look, there's really no difference yet. But if you look carefully, there's a little square right there and there. And then I'm really bad at drawing hands. But then you start his hand. So you start off with a little line going on the left side of his arm. Just start off with a little, that probably didn't sound like him, but yeah, that's what you do. And then on the right side, start a little line up, curve it. So it's like half of a cup, I guess. And then bring it in and make his thumb. And then the probably part of his thumb, if you look at your hand, like if you could see, you've got like this line right there. So then you draw that on his hand. And then above his thumb, do a little half circle, because it's like one of his fingers. And then do another one. And so on and so forth, until you have four of them. About four. And then you'll know whenever you have to. Well, you'll know whenever you're done with that. And so, just do that for a little bit. I'm horrible with that. If this is your first time drawing Link, which it is for me, then you'll probably be really horrible at drawing his hand. Most likely. Because drawing his hand for some reason is like super hard. So I think I'll just skip this part until I get his. Wait. I just finished. It's so ugly. Okay, so then you have to have his little fist right there. And his hands like that, at this finger and that finger, there's a line going up. That's part of the shield. And so then you have to make it kind of slanted though, so that it looks more like it's realistic-ish. And then you bring it down, and it should. Then you have to try to make it disappear around his wrist, or else you're gonna have to draw it all around. Then you have, if you want, this is an option. Just slant the picture, and once you slant it, it will be easier to draw this part. So after you draw that, if you need to, you can just draw his either shield that he has, like that one, if he has a phantom shield or anything, then you could just draw the phantom shield in its place. But after that, just slant the picture, turn it, and bring it down, like the line, all the way down to his wrist. And then above that, start the other part of it that makes it look more defensible, and bring that down to his elbow. So I guess I should show you guys what it looks like right now. This is what it looks like if you follow the directions. It's like this. And then after that, you bring it. Then you bring the line diagonally down to about where his belt would be, which is usually about right. Wait, no, it's bigger than that. Well, he's got a belt right after, like, where we drew the his waist ended at. Draw a circle that's medium sized. So it's about that size. I guess it's kind of big. You could make it smaller. And then put a little spiral on it. And so now we have to start the bottom part of his waist if we're going to finish the shield. From part of his arm, like from, if on my picture, I started it around right there. So it looks like he's, like it looks better. And about halfway through, you'll have to put, actually when you're done with that part, do this onto the belt so then you'll know where to end it. Just put like two little lines right there. And bring down the waist to the first line. And then connect the line across to that side. And that's the first part of it.
Okay.
OMG!
Well, this might have to be a two-parter. But it should look like that.
Okay. And then you bring down his shirt a little bit farther down. Oh, God, that doesn't look good. Cool, you have to bring it down to about a centimeter, maybe, down. And then bring his other part of, like, the bottom part of his shirt a little bit down on the other side. And then you have to connect them.
It should look like this. I have to end part one, maybe, just to see if I've got enough space for this. If it's not, I'll just say this is the still part one. Just wait.
Okay, everyone, I checked the camera, and I've still got time. Okay, so at the end, it should look something like this, from where we left off at. And then we're going to draw his leg, like the first part of his leg. And that's actually probably really easy to you guys. It's just, you have to, wait, I can't really explain this. So then you bring down the two lines, and then kind of make the line a little curved down.
So, because he's wearing like these boots or something. So it looks something like that.
And then after you draw that part, bring down his boot. And then, at the bottom of that, make a little curve for where his foot would be. Bring it back. And then bring it up. And if you should probably shade that in a little, since he's wearing, like, boots. But in the front of it, shade it in a little more. Or you just shade in the whole thing overall.
So at the end of that part, it should look like that.
Oh, and just to note, in this picture, his legs look really short. But really, they're not. It's just because
that part right here, like that part of his shirt, is covering up the other part of his leg. He's really not that short. It just looks like that.
And it also looks like that in the game, too. He looks kind of short, like his legs look short. But he's really not. Okay. And then you sew after that, you do the other leg. And now once you get a little bit down, curve it over, put it up. So after that, you bring down his other part of his boot, and you need to draw a little line straight across, curve it up, and then bring it on. His other boot looks more straight than the other one since he's standing in a different pose, I guess. I'm trying to get it good so like you guys can see it. Let's see, so he do it. Okay. I can't do it! Well, basically just try to copy the first leg and just make it a little wider. Like, not wider, make it more diagonal. And since it's diagonal, it's not gonna be so, I don't know how to say it, straight. Well, it should look something like, if this is on the camera, it should look like that. Except for that leg's too straight now. So I guess we have to move that one forward a little bit. Feet are kind of hard on Link for some reason. Not Link, just like Toon Link. But after a while, I'm going to start making more advanced videos on how to draw stuff. Because I'm a really good drawer. So are my friends, like Mason. Yeah, that looks better. Okay, so that's how it should look now. And now that we've done that, we can actually start finishing off the shield, where you bring that down a little more, and at the bottom, slant it in so it's like, to explain. Well, we'll just put it this way. After you do that, draw something like this and put a little curve down there. What? Oh, gee. So then you put the curve down there and you bring the rest of it up to a little bit above his elbow. Because in the middle of that, he's got, a metal thingy is right there. So it should look something like that. But then after that, try to kind of erase a little bit above the line that you made. Because that's supposed to be a metal, there's supposed to be a metal, whole thingy right there, and when you put that across, it won't look like whatever you thought it would look like. And after that, you just bring down the shield line to the normal part that you had it at the bottom, bring it up, and it should end it around his elbow.
So at the end, it looks like that. Oh yeah, and if you can't see something, just pause the video so you can just draw it.
And now we're about done with him. We just need to draw his head now. So I would start off usually putting a line above the tip right around there, and then, whoa, there's a phone. And then you got kind of draw part of the circle, I'll just show you what the head looks like whenever I'm done.
So I'm gonna skip this part because this usually takes me about an hour. So I'll just come back to you guys and like really fast. Okay guys, I finally finished drawing the face. Here's what it looks like. You should have this on full screen and on pause.
Too late now, I don't have three wine. Okay. We're about done with Link. The last thing left is hat thing. I think he's like a dwarf hat. So it's blowing sideways because most of the time in the game, he's mostly like on a boat or something, sailing, doing something. And so his hat's really easy. It may look hard if some people think so, but it's super easy. Just the bottom, like, just try to make the lines for his hat. Just try to make them more solid.
So at the end, it looks like this. And that's just how you draw to know. Wait, actually it's not. We forgot one thing.
I just can't believe we totally forgot this. After that, you've got to add his. Get out of the way, all this junk is in the way. Oh, wait, he's off of me. Okay, we've got to add that fairy thing that guides him. Because, yes, it may sound creepy, but he's got a fairy. To start off the fairy, you could just draw like a circle. And then just at the bottom part, am I running out of memory?
Just wait, I need to check something really fast.
Okay, never mind, I've got 5 minutes left. Okay, so you just draw a little line and then you draw another one down here and put a little curve on it and then curve that back up.
So it would look like this. Just draw that.
And then at the top, it's got longer wings. So just draw something a little bit longer. A little bit longer. Little laddie. And at the end of that part, try not to make them not like look too rectangular. Just say it that way. Because if you do, then that's probably the hardest part about drawing the fairy dude, person, thing, girl. Is because you just can never get it to not be a rectangle. Well, you can, but it's hard.
So then after you draw the top wings, it should look like that.
And then in the middle, there's like a little circle, but since it's glowing, try to make the circle like kind of look kind of dusty-ish. Like not dusty, but like not solid, more fuzzy. Because if you make it look solid, then you'll just totally know it's totally fake. The center of it's supposed to be light, but since it's pencil sketching kind of, that's gonna be hard. And then in the middle, put lines on the wings. But before you do that, I'll just show you what they have to look like. Because I don't want you guys to do it wrong. Okay.
So they should look like that on the fairy, you see them? They have to look like that.
And then, I'm just doing something. Okay. And then there's like these little sparkle thingies that are everywhere all around it, but they're really mostly at the bottom because they like fall off of her kind of. So like at the bottom of her, then just draw these little sparkles things. Wait, I'm at the last part, Mom!
Get past your bedtime.
Okay.
Okay. I'm out of time, and good thing too, because we're at the end. So then you just draw it and it'll look like that. And that's how you draw Toon Link. Here's what he looks like. I got that dirt on my screen. Nasty dirt. The dirt makes his eye look dirty. But so that's how you draw Toon Link. See you next time for more epic heroes and stuff. If there's a specific hero you want me to draw, try and put it in the comments, and if I think it's a good hero, I'll draw him. That's all for now. Goodbye.